It gives me great pleasure this morning to welcome you all to Gothenburg, Sweden, for the World Library Information Congress, IFLA 76, General Conference and Assembly. I'd also like to recognize and thank Professor Van Sail, Deputy Vice Chancellor of Research at Stellenbosch University, South Africa, as one of our distinguished guests for his presence here today. And I'd also like to take the opportunity to thank Stellenbosch University for their support for me as president of your association and for their continued support for the next year. There is a long IFLA tradition in this country. Our Swedish colleagues were numbered among the founding members of our federation who met in Edinburgh, Scotland in 1927. The inaugural president of IFLA was the Swede Isak Koiling, who served in this capacity from 1927 to 1931. Koiling was then director of the Royal Library in Stockholm. IFLA has held three annual conferences in Sweden: Stockholm in 1930, Lund and Malmö in 1960, and returning to Stockholm in 1990. The latter met under the theme Libraries, Information for Knowledge, which is, by way, rather close to my presidential theme some 20 years on. 2010 is therefore the fourth time that IFLA has convened in Sweden, a distinction that no other country holds. Not just because it is inspired by my presidential theme, or because it promotes equitable access to information, but due to the fact that I passionately believe that knowledge is a critical factor influencing all spheres of life. To reiterate what I said in Milan, without knowledge, all effort is naught. Without sound, accurate and reliable knowledge, the decisions and actions we and others take can have disastrous consequences for a very long time. Knowledge is the key to success. Further, access to knowledge is critical for the equal growth of all communities, societies, cultures and nations. Libraries, as essential providers of information, have an important role to play in the creation of new knowledge. As a major source of information, libraries serve a wide spectrum of information seekers who are not only critical, but central to the facilitation of knowledge generation. Equal access to knowledge serves to ensure the stability of nations and the assurance of world peace. Access to knowledge, however, is not dependent-free. Firstly, to paraphrase Professor Jan Voithaus of Germany, Gutenberg's invention of print with movable letters caused books and print media to become the core of information and its transmission. Literacy was and is key to power and empowerment. The ability to produce and preserve the printed word are therefore key attributes of power and empowerment. Available to all of us, events that are not to be missed. You will have the opportunity to see colleagues from all over the world at sessions over coffee for dinner and in one of the many nice spots that this city has to offer. We look forward to a good conference, and I can smile now because I'm getting to the end. A good atmosphere, good professional experiences and development, the formation of new networks and the renewal of old friendships. Welcome to Gothenburg, an open city with easy access. Welcome to Sweden, to the Society of Knowledge and Sustainability, and welcome to the 2010 World Library and Information Congress, a congress in progress. And it is with much pleasure that I declare IFLA 76 General Conference and Assembly open. Thank you.